Dear students, let's now discuss some common defects of vision for human eye. A few of these defects you might have studied in your early classes too. The first one we'll study is the short-sightedness, or it is also called near-sightedness or myopia. This is a defect of vision in which distant objects, the objects which are placed very far away from human eye, are not clearly visible, are not clearly seen by eye. This is because eye lens fails to focus the image of a distant object on the retina. Here you can see this is the realistic situation of a human eye, on which when a parallel light rays from far away object incident on eye lens, it converges the rays at a point in front of retina, or you can say the eye lens is not able to produce a sharp image on retina. Such kind of eye defect can be corrected by introducing a diverging lens in the spectacle. So if we place a diverging lens in front of the human eye, again you can see when the parallel rays incident on the eye, then due to the combined effect of diverging lens and the eye lens, the final image will be produced on retina and I will be able to see the object clearly. So here we can write that myopia can be corrected, or its correction can be done by diverging lenses in spectacles. Similar to this, another eye defect which is also very common is farsightedness or farsightedness, or it is also called hypermetropia, or it is also called hyperopia. And this is the eye defect in which the objects at near point of eye, which are close to eye, are not clearly seen by the human eye. And this is because the eye lens again fails to produce a sharp image on retina. Here you can see in front of human eye, if an object is placed at a near point of the eye, the image is produced, or the rays after passing through the eye lens converges at a point behind the retina. So it produced a blurred image on retina, not a sharp image, so I cannot see the image clearly. Now in this situation, this is corrected, this eye defect is corrected by introducing a converging lens in front of human eye in the spectacles. So here you can see again, if we place a converging lens, then again when the light rays incident on the converging lens, then the combined effect of converging lens and the eye lens is that the final image is produced on retina and I'll be able to see the image clearly. So here you can see that the correction of hypermetropia can be done by using converging lenses. Another defect which is not very common, but it is used in general for so many cases, that is astigmatism. And this is an eye defect in which here we can write eye lens fails to produce sharp image on retina from light in all directions. Here you can see if this is the picture of a net, and in various directions of the net on eye lens when light rays are falling, and say if this is the retina, the image produced for the net on retina will be distorted in different directions, and such kind of defect can be corrected by introducing a cylindrical lens in front of the eye. When a cylindrical lens is placed at a specific angle so that the final image is corrected, then image can be clearly seen by the eye. The object can be clearly seen by the eye due to proper sharp image formation on the retina.